let's talk to God. Have a seat. Before we have to sit and start, welcome to worship. We have some new friends here. Is there a new friend? We have JJ. JJ, can you say hi to everyone? You can take a look around and say hi. Can everybody say hi to JJ? Hi, JJ. He's visiting us today. So I pray that you'll have a good time. You can sit right over there in the red circle. So I can see you better, JJ. Red circle over there? Yeah. All right. Let's talk to God. So talking to God is praying to God. 우리 기도하는 거예요, 하나님한테. 그러니까 everyone, Messi and Melina, Messi, can you sit straight? You sit straight on the apple, where the apple is, on the rock? Yeah. And Melina, you can just stay right behind, or don't try to stick to each other, all right? Because it's a worship time, all right? I want you to all focus. So close your eyes, hands together, 손 이렇게, 손. Bow down your head and let's talk to God. Say, dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for the sun. Thank you for the church. Thank you for our friends. Thank you for our teachers. Thank you for loving us. Even though sometimes we're not good. Even though sometimes we're not good. Help us to listen. Help us to obey. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Good job. So guys, time to go over some of the rules because I see you guys might have forgotten. So first rule, we have to introduce our friend Peter Pander again. Say hi to Peter Pander. Hi everyone. I'm so glad you guys are here again. I'm so glad JJ is visiting us today. You guys, we're going to go over the rule. Oh, Messi, this is for you. Messi, we have some rules you have to follow. Okay? Peter is talking to you. You have to sit up. Sit up on the floor. Sit up on the rock. Put your bottom on the floor and then crisscross applesauce. You guys are doing a good job. Yeah. And you guys are doing a good job. Hajina, you have to sit up. And then with your eyes, look up. Messi, it's time to look up. Look up whom? Look up at whom? Who do you have to look up?
At the teacher.
Look up at the teacher talking, trying to teach, right? Yeah, so look up at the teacher. And let's turn on your ears. Let's go. The other ear. Oliver, you're not looking up. You have to look up. And did you turn on your ear? Yeah, look. So listen up. And then let's catch a bubble. Daniel, you're not catching a bubble. Catch a bubble. If you catch a bubble, you cannot speak, so zip up. It's time to zip up. And only put your hand up when it's an answer to the question that I'm talking, all right? And something that's related to what I'm talking, all right? So Peter Panda is going to be here and see who's doing the best job, all right? And then you guys know if you do a good job, you all get the stickers. And then when your sticker chart is full, you can pick a prize. We have some good prizes, all right? Yeah, but still, we have stickers here, right, teachers? We're going to give you guys out multiple stickers if you're going to do a good job, all right? Yes, Connor? Jesus really loves you, so we're going to learn more about that too today. All right, let's all stand up and sing our song. How much God wants us to be in His forever family. All right, so zip up, look up, sit up, listen up. You guys are all keeping the rules. Peter is looking at you guys. Messi, are you ready? Sit up on your bottom. Zip up. 하진이 앉으세요. Can you guys think of some of the wonderful things that Jesus did? Jesus did so many things, right? Some of the things only Jesus could do, there are some amazing things that Jesus did. Do you guys know what do we call? Yeah, those are called miracles, right? Yeah, yeah, Kira, go ahead. What are some of the things that, great things that Jesus did? I couldn't hear that. Can you speak up? He healed people. That's amazing. That's a miracle that Jesus performed. Yeah. Yeah, he made everything. Yes, Ian?
He didn't cry when she was baby.
He didn't cry when he... Yeah, maybe not. I'm not sure. It doesn't say in the Bible, so I'm not totally sure, but he was perfect, even when he was a baby.
Yeah, but
yes, Daniel?
In the Bible, I saw him, I read the Bible, and I saw a picture of him crying.
Baby Jesus crying? When he was born, like a newborn, I'm pretty sure he cried a little bit, but not too loud. I don't know. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Put your hand down. Put your hand down. Hand out, wait, put your hand down. All right, guys, take a look. There are so many miracles that Jesus did. Let's take a look at some of the pictures. So what are some of the miracles that Jesus performed? He healed the sick people. Do you see the mud in the eyes of one of a person, one of the men here? Do you remember?
I know that.
What's the story?
I know that.
Do you know the story how Jesus healed a blind man? He put a mud on the eyes of the blind man, and he was suddenly able to see. That's a miracle.
He had to wash it off.
Yeah, that was another story about how Jesus healed a Roman soldier, centurion, and Jesus healed a girl who was lying, who was dead. He brought him to life. And yeah, she was sleeping. What's the story about in the water? Do you guys remember what miracle that is?
Oh, yeah.
Kira, do you have an answer? No? Okay. Caleb? Okay, Rowan?
Well, I have that story in the Bible.
About what story? Yeah, Peter walked on the water. Jesus walked on the water first, and then Peter wanted to walk on the water too. So Peter was able to walk on the water for a little short time. Yes, put your hand down. Put your hand down. So there's so many miracles that Jesus performed, but out of all these miracles that Jesus has done while he was living on the earth, can you guys guess what was the greatest thing that Jesus did? These are all greatest things, but what is the one greatest thing that Jesus did? Ayo. Yeah, that was the greatest miracle and thing that Jesus did. Even though Jesus didn't do anything wrong, he led mean people to kill him on the cross. And the Bible says it, so we know it's true, right? So we're going to learn from our Bible today. And we're going to memorize a verse about what Jesus did. And so the greatest thing, just as Ayush told us, that Jesus performed was that he died on the cross because he loves us. All right, so the first of the memory verse today. Yeah, the address of the verse today is from 1 Corinthians 15, 3. 4, 5. So let's all open up our Bible. Zip up. Open up your Bible and say 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5 together. Ready? Three times. Ready? Go. 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. We're going to all stand up and then stand on one leg, left leg, and say that address three times together. Ready? Go. 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. Make sure you're making sound, not just standing on one leg, all right? So let's stand on the right leg. Let's not be silly. Daniel, let's not be silly. Try to balance and say that three times. Ready, go. 1 Corinthians 15:3, 4, 5. 1 Corinthians 15:3, 4, 5. 1 Corinthians 15:3, 4, 5. All right, this time we're going to jump up and down and say three times. Ready, go. 1 Corinthians 15:3, 4, 5. 1 Corinthians 15:3, 4, 5. 1 Corinthians 15:3, 4, 5. All right, let's all sit down. And I have a book, I bookmarked where the 1 Corinthians is, all right? So, guys, zip up, zip up. Kira, have a seat. Rowanie, have a seat. And it says, do you guys see it's small, but it says 1 Corinthians, and then chapter number is 15. 15 was over here. 15, and verse 3, 4, 5, I highlighted here, and I'm going to read it to you. It says, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scripture, that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the scripture, and he was seen. That's a long verse, but you guys understand everything, right? So we're going to memorize that verse. Yes, Danielle? Very good. So you're advanced, but we're going to try. So you're going to have an easy time, but we're going to review it. We're going to help other kids to memorize it, all right? All right. So the first part, what was the first part? 1 Corinthians 15, 3-4. The first part, what is it? Cross? Is it cross? Did I say cross when I was reciting? Cross also represents Christ, Jesus, right? So we go, Christ died. Christ died on the cross. Zip up, guys. Zip up. Kira, 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 Rowan, zip up and look up. Everyone, everyone, catch a bubble. And Kayla, can you put that away? You shouldn't have anything in your hand. Are you okay, Rowan? I'm sorry. You can come back when you're ready. So the Bible says Christ died for our sins. Who is Christ, guys? Christ is Jesus, God the Son. He didn't do anything wrong, but because he loved us, God sent Jesus down on the earth. And just like our friend said, he was a perfect baby when he was a baby, when he was growing up just like you, he never ever said or done or thought anything wrong. He was perfect, but he let other people kill him on the cross. He did that because he loves us so much. Because the Bible says all have sinned. So what are some of the things that we sin, guys? Ian? Be rude to other kids, right? That's a sin. Caleb? Punching and pushing and kicking. Those are all sin. Yes, Daniel? Yeah, that's very bad. All these things, the Bible says everyone have sinned. And the Bible says, guys, put your hand down, put your hand down. Look up, look up. Kira, look up. And the Bible says the punishment for sin is to be separated from God forever in a terrible place of suffering. But God loves us so much, God doesn't want that to happen. That's why Jesus, when Jesus was dying on the earth, yeah, Kira, zip up. I didn't call on you. Can you put your stuff away? You're distracted. Put it away, please. So, because Jesus, God didn't want that to happen to us, Jesus, instead of us, he was punished on the cross. And he, let's see. So, the Christ died for our sins. So, this is a dark heart. That is a sin. So, Christ died for our sin, the dark heart, the want to do our own way. Instead of saying, yes, mom, yes, dad, we just go our own way. Even though we say it's time to zip up, you just want to go out your own way and speak anything, right? That's a thing that we are very impatient, right? Yeah, put your hand down. It's time to listen. So Christ died for our sin. And how do we know it's true? Because it's written in the Bible. Scripture, the Bible is also sometimes called the scripture. Can you guys repeat after me? Scriptures. And it goes in accordance with the scriptures. Can you say that? In accordance with the scriptures. In accordance with the scripture. How do we know that Christ died for our sins? Because it's in the Bible. We know it's true. Because everything that's in the Bible, which is also called scripture, God's word, is perfect and true. You can totally believe what's in the Bible. Yes, Piper. Your tummy hurts? Do you want to take a minute? 선생님, 여기 배가 아프대요. Piper. You can maybe stay, get some water, and then sit down in the back. All right, so Christ died for our sin according to the scripture. So he died, guys. So what happened after he died on the cross? We're going to learn this next week. No, he was crucified on the cross. And then what happened? He was buried. Bible says a young, not young, wealthy man whose name was Joseph, he brought down the dead body, and he put Jesus' dead body in the tomb, a new tomb, a rock cave. It was kind of like a cave. And then he was buried there. And he was just lying there, and he was buried, and they put a closure. Do you guys see a big rock? They put a big door out of that was made cut from the hard rock, and they cover the doorway so nobody would be able to come and take away Jesus' body. They made sure all the Roman soldiers, they wanted to make sure that nobody take away Jesus' body and then claim, oh, Jesus is risen. They wanted to make sure they so put Jesus' body. So it was, zip up. Kira, I didn't call on you yet, okay? So if you see this picture, it goes, he was buried. Can you guys repeat after me? He was buried. So he was buried. Let's bury him in the under the ground. He was buried. He was buried. But did he stay buried forever? What happened?
He rose back up again.
Yeah, and then he rose again. Do you guys know what day he rose? Yes, Kayla? On the third day. After he died, on the third day, he rose again. An angel came down from heaven. They rolled away this big heavy stone that nobody could ever be. It's very, very hard to roll away, but the angels rolled away the stone, and Jesus was gone. Jesus rose again. So if you see this picture, is he rose again. Can you guys do it and repeat after me? He rose again. He rose again on the third day. And how do we know it's true? It's in the Bible, true word of God, which is also called the scripture. So we go in accordance with the scriptures. Let's do it one more time. In accordance with the scriptures. Yeah. And then the amazing thing is that, what does it say? What does it represent? Two eyes. He was, yes, Ian. Yeah, it makes you focus if you with two eyes. But when you see the picture, it goes, he was seen. It's not that, oh, Jesus was risen. I don't know, somebody might have said. But he appeared to a lot of people. First, he appeared to Mary Magdalene. And then he appeared to the disciples, 12 disciples, 12 disciples. And then the Bible says one day at the same time, he was seen by 500 people. So they were able to see Jesus' risen, resurrected by with their two eyes. That means they are the witness, because they saw the Jesus who died and who was buried, but Jesus who came alive again. So it was true because it's in the Bible. So we go, he was seen. Can you guys repeat after me? He was seen. That's the memory verse. So let's do from here. Ready? I'm going to show you how to do with the motion. Melina, Kira, look up. It goes, he was buried.
He rose again
on the third day
in accordance with the scriptures.
And he was seen. Yeah, that's a long verse, right? So we're going to go from the start. Do you guys remember? It's been about 10 minutes. So let's open up our Bible and ready, go. 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. Christ died for our sins. Thumbs down. In accordance with the scriptures, that he was buried, that he rose again, on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures, and he was seen by many people. All right, we're gonna practice this memory verse with this memory verse board. So, 혜린 선생님, 소린 선생님 나와가지고 이거 좀 들어주세요. So, we're gonna take a turn. We're gonna pick a name, and then the one who's picked, we'll just choose any picture card from here. We're gonna take it away and then try to memorize it without that one picture. All right? So, 혜린 선생님이 이거 하고, you guys move around, and then I'll give you the name, and you can call on the name. So, 여기 서세요. 물어보세요, 있나? 얘부터 물어보면. Is Lucas here? Put your hand down. Lucas? Lucas is not here, so let's pull it from here. Aiden? We're gonna all have a turn, okay? Jenna, it's Jenna's turn. Everybody, that's exactly why I made this. Everybody's gonna have a fair chance if you attend every week, okay? Okay, he took this out. So let's memorize, recite the verse without seeing this part, all right? Everyone ready? Go ahead and recite it. Ready? Go. 1 Corinthians 3, 4, 5. 너는 안 해도 돼. Scriptures that he was buried, that he rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scripture, and he was seen. Very good. All right, next person. Is Audrey here? Audrey is not here today. Kira, can you stop? Everybody's gonna have a turn, okay? Andrew? Andrew, is Andrew here?
No.
Riley. All right, are you guys ready? Go ahead. Ready? Go.
15, 3, 4, 5.
Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scripture, that he was buried, he rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scripture. Very good. All right. 또 누구 여기 있다. 있나 봐. L. 그다음. Ready, guys? Ready, everyone? Looks like a tomb. All right, everyone. Ready, go.
1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. Christ died for our sins.
To the scripture. Buried. Rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures. And then he was seen. All right.
Yeah.
윌리엄 청? 얘는 아닌가? 오케이, 그럼 다른 친구 여기 해보자. 아, 소피아 is not here. 해리슨? 해리슨도 안 왔어요. 헤일리? 헤일리? Pictures are gone. Can you guys still do it? Yeah? All right. Ready? Go. In accordance with the scripture, seen. Very good.
Taylor?
이거 이렇게 순서대로. 크게 얘기하지. Is Kaylee here? Yay, Kaylee's here in the back. Kaylee한테 가주세요. 예. Yeah. 알라이트 에브리원. Are you guys ready? We're gonna, I'm gonna see who's doing the best job. Alright? And then clap for you. Ready? Go! 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scripture. That he was buried, that he rose again on the third day in accordance with the scripture, then he was seen. Good job. 다음 또 있어? 이거, 이거야. 크게 얘기해. Ian! In accordance with the scripture. All right, guys, ready? Ready? Ready, go! Corinthians 15, 3, 4. With the scripture, he was buried, rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scripture, seen. All right, two more. 얘 말고. 하라? 하라's not here. 케일린 게 다른 애 없나? 크게 얘기해. 신원? 신원. 신원이 안 왔어요? 오. 우진! Your name is chosen, 우진.
No. Yeah.
All right. Ready, guys? Go ahead. Ready? Daniel, Daniel, can you please go back to your seat and do it? Ready? Go. Scripture that he was rose again in accordance with the scripture. See. All right, last one. Who is it? Ian Kim? Do we have Ian Kim?
Jason?
Jason, come out and pick the last card. Guys, zip up. Guys, we're still worshiping time, so zip up. Daniel. Here. Okay, ready, guys? Ready, go.
First Corinthians 15:3-5.
Christ died for our sins. In accordance with the scripture, buried, rose again. With the scripture. Good job making effort. Good job, everyone. All right. Thank you so much. All right, guys. So, guys, the Bible says if you haven't believed in what Jesus has done, that he died on the cross and he rose again, you're going to have to be punished for your own sin. Kira, zip up. We all go by the rule. Everybody gets picked, not because they want to. It was just because they have their names on it. Okay? So if you wait patiently, you're going to have a turn, all right? Yes, Ian. Yeah, so Bible says if you don't believe in what Jesus has done for you, then you're going to have to be punished for your own sin. And that the punishment is to be separate from God. Zip up. Shh. Everyone, sit up. Sit up. Sit up and look up. But guys, if you believe in what Jesus has done for you, then you don't have to worry about being punished by God. Yeah, so if you believe that, just know that you are forgiven. You're going to have an eternal life in God's forever family. So if you guys didn't believe in Jesus as your Savior, if you guys didn't believe what Jesus has done, but you know that you're a sinner, sometimes you sin, you know that you have to be forgiven, and you want to become a child of God, please come talk to me after I pray so I can tell you from the Bible how to become a child of God. All right? All right, everyone, let's all bow down. Close your eyes, hands together, and let's talk to God.
Dear God,
thank you for Jesus.
Thank you for keeping your promise
to send your son Jesus.
Help us to love you more
and obey you more.
We pray this
in Jesus' name.
Amen.